Over the years, women have fought for the right to vote. Women have demonstrated for equal rights, equal opportunities, and equal pay. Now women are fighting to get into the boardroom, but the door to the executive suite is closed to most women.
I think a glass ceiling is that invisible barrier that exists when a person of obvious talent and ability reaches a certain point in, say, mid-management, and doesn't get any further.
Today, 50% of all women work. Women have made significant gains in entry-level jobs and first levels of management. But according to the Department of Labor, most women reach a point in their careers where they don't go any further. Those higher-up positions are out of reach.
Women do not have that built-in good old girls network. You hear so much about the good old boys network. And so they don't hear about the positions that are opening up, and it's sometimes just done over a lunch or a dinner, and women are excluded. I think that's another barrier, the recruitment of women for those positions.
The Department of Labor reports that only 2% of upper-level management positions are filled by women. The chance of a woman getting a high-ranking corporate job is just a little over 4%.
When I look at the statistics for South Dakota alone, the workforce consists of 51.7 women. And when you look at the management positions, it's like about 2%. And so that's why I think we do need to take a look at the glass ceiling.
When women do move up the corporate ladder, it's rarely as quickly or as far as their male counterparts. A new study of MBA graduates reports that women with their Masters of Business started out at the same salary level as men, but within 10 years, they were making 20% less.
We can't afford to waste half the brain power of this country anymore. We're in too competitive a situation with the rest of the world. But there are a lot of women whose talents are going to waste in the meantime.